I first fell in love with Wytham Woods in the archives because I read about it before I walked the woods. And then when you go there, you can really feel why Charles Elton and so many other researchers have fallen in love with Wytham.
People do occasionally look up from their bramble bush where they're studying caterpillars or whatever and realise that this is actually a very beautiful place.
One of the things that's really interesting about Wytham Woods is from the beginning there's been this weaving between science and artistic expression. I'm Dr Georgina Montgomery. I'm a historian of science and interdisciplinary scholar, and I've been working at the Bodleian for a fellowship for the last few months. I will always remember the first time the grey box was delivered to me at the reading room with the folders of materials bound in cream ribbon, and it literally just felt like a gift. My research here takes me beyond the library walls of the Bodleian. One of the things that's wonderful about being in Oxford and conducting this research is you get to read something in the Bodleian reading room, like a letter from Charles Elton, but then walk through the city to actually see the physical places that are still there today. One of the things that I've always found really beautiful and emotional about archival research is that you get to know a side of somebody that you've never physically been able to meet. Charles Elton made mistakes and had failures and had weaknesses. He had articles rejected. So you really see the human behind the so-called founding father, but also you see in the photos, when you see the groups of researchers working together, the collaborative nature of ecology since the 1940s to today. In September 2021, we did a workshop that was looking at Wytham Woods as a place for scientific and artistic expression. We really connected with our love for Wytham, wanting to use art as well as the history of science to talk about collaboration and team building and the way in which different perspectives and contributions can come together to make something greater than its parts.
Collaborative approach is important because you learn from the people you're collaborating with. You know, the artists will point out, you know, the beauty of the place, which might have escaped the scientists, or the scientists will point out to the artists that the incredible butterfly they're staring at is actually an invasive species and ought to be murdered.
And walking in the footsteps of those who came before us that really saw this as a scientific environment but didn't see it that as a problem, with it also being a site of inspiration and a site of art. One of the things that I've really loved as a researcher and a fellow here at the Bodleian has been the opportunity to do outreach and engagement events with the public. My research has always been motivated by wanting science to be a more diverse and inclusive place. So I look at historical examples of where we can see diversity and inclusion and collaboration. Wytham Woods was particularly progressive about the integration of women in ecology.
By 1950, there are more women doing the undergraduate field ecology class with Charles Elton than there are men.
And it's exciting to be able to take that to school-age children, for example, to promote greater diversity and inclusion in science today. It's too easy to imagine science done by some lone genius out there working on their own, when in actual fact, great science is done collaboratively. That's true today and it's been true historically.